I want to introduce you to Minsar Ghatiani, who has just come back to Palestine from a tour to Tunis, Italy, and Germany, I understand.
Good afternoon. From Palestine, from the prisoners' tent, with the families of the prisoners, we are here from Nablus Square. In the prisoners' tent, we say our message to all the world. Be with our prisoners, that this day is the 31 day. They were sick, they were in hard conditions. They need treatment, they need help, they need your solidarity. Not just to be with them in the tent, they need your voice, your letters, your messages to the United Nations, demonstration at your countries, to be with the prisoners, because they are in open hunger strike from the 17th of April, not just for needs to be in a good situation in the prison. No, they have a lot of things they need to stop the administrative detention. They want to stop the isolated cells for the prisoners. They want to continue their studying at the universities. They want to continue their studying for the young whom are under the age of 16, and to return back the youngs to the prisoners with the others, not to isolate them, because the Israeli occupation wants from the young, especially, to keep them away from the Palestinian issue, to empty their minds from education, to empty their minds from the Palestinian issue, not to let them to continue their studying, not to let them to be in a good culture. So it is very important thing that the prisoners want. They want to let their families to visit them twice per month, not just one time, because it is the duty of the Red Cross from the United Nations. They stopped it for 1 year, just one time. And all the families lost their visit for their sons, because the security from the occupation. They want to allow them to have two books each month. So the prisoners want a lot of things for their culture, for their life, and the main thing that they want now to be free. Something very important to tell you about. There were a treatment between the Palestinian Authority and the occupation to free Palestinians. They free one group, two group, three group, the fourth group. The Zionists didn't free them until now. Why? Because they are from the from Jerusalem, and Palestine occupied 1948. They said that they are Israeli. Whom are they? Karim Yunus, whom now 36 at the prison, and he is now in open hunger strike. Maher Yunus, Walid Daqa, and others from Jerusalem and 1948. So it is illegal to let them until now at prison. No one until now at prison. Karim Yunus, 36 years. Maher Yunus, 36 years. Walid Daqa, 34 years. Whom until now at the prison, except George Abdullah, whom at French prison, and Carlos at the French prison. Just them and the Palestinian whom are arrested by the Zionist occupation. Now, we are afraid of our prisoners. Why? Because they lost of their weight 25 kilo. Today morning and yesterday, they began to take the prisoners whom are in open hunger strike to hospitals. But look, the Zionists now, this time, they made the hospital military hospitals in the prison. So it is very dangerous. Why? Because Before they were, the prisoners went to the hospitals inside our area 1948. So our comrades, the people of Palestinian whom are from 1948 can visit them, can make demonstration around the hospital. Their families can enter our area 1948 and see their sons. And the doctors, the European Parliament, the Canadian Parliament, the American Parliament, now the lawyers, the ministry, now it is forbidden to see the prisoners because they are in a military hospital inside the prisons. And we don't know anything about our sons, about the prisoners. It is very dangerous. The second thing that they isolated the leader of the open hunger strike battle. They put them in isolated prisons, in isolated cells, like Marwan al-Barghouti in Ascalon, Munzir Khalaf in Ascalon. They were from the beginning of the open hunger strike, 31 day until now. Ahmed Saadat, Ahed Abu Ghulme, and a lot of others, they were Wajdi Jude, Abbas Sayed, they were all of them in isolated cell. What is this mean? This means that they want to make spaces between the leaders of the open hunger strike not to be in contact. But the prisoners are very clever. They made standby leaders to continue their open hunger strike. The third dangerous for the prisoners, they took the prisoners while they were in open hunger strike by Bosta, which we called it by the language of a prison Bosta, a small bus. It is like oven in summer and frigidaire in winter. They put the prisoners whom are in open hunger strike, and it will take them him for 10 hours, 12 hours, 36 hours, 24 hours in this iron bus. And he was tied by iron. He was in open hunger strike to take him from a prison to another. And you hear by media that they took Ahmed Saadat from Ascalon to Huleyhikdar. They took Marwan al-Barghouti from Majiddo to Ascalon. It was the distance just 2 hours. But by this oven or this frigidaire, it will take more than 24 hours. So my message that what the Zionists are making with our prisoners, they are killing them by our eyes. We are showing our sons killing. The death of our sons now, we are watching the death of our sons. So we need all the world support in their struggle. We need all of you to be with our sons, with our leaders. They are in a battle. They are in a human and a legal battle against the occupation. So be with us. This is my message. While I was in Italy, while I was in Germany, in Tunis, all of you were with me. Not just because I am pre-prisoner, no, because I was speaking about the prisoners. So be with us. We trust you. Be with us in your solidarity with our prisoners. Thanks.
How often were you a political prisoner yourself? When were you a political prisoner? When were you in prison?
Oh, I was arrested for 3 times. The first time I was arrested while I was 17 years old at my secondary school. The second time, 2009, it was very hard for me and for my family because they arrested me. The Zionist arrested me with my brother Nasser. And until now, the view of my mother, an old woman, 85 years, when she say for the Zionist captain, take one and leave one. When he release, come and take the other. Please don't take my eyes. Leave one eye. I want to see with one of my eyes. it's my mother. It was hard for me. I wrote about this. The third time I was arrested in 2013. Why? Because I was in my land area, which occupied in 1948. They want me to take permission to visit Haifa, Yafa, Hakka. I will not take permission from the Zionists to visit Hakka, Yafa, or Haifa. So they arrested me and they put me for 6 months at a prison. I was deported in exile after I finished my studying at the university for 5 years. I was through my studying at the university in house arrested and not allowed to go out from Nablus city. For 23 years, I was not allowed to go outside Palestine. This is the first time I went outside Palestine, and immediately my voice was the voice of a prisoner. So I wrote a study about the youngest female prisoners whom are under 16 years old. It will be published in Italy, Germany, and English. Thanks for all of you whom helped me to take this study. And I give it for all my comrades in Italy, Germany, and Tunis to speak about this study. It is not a Miassar study. It is your study to speak about the youngest female prisoners, girls, whom arrested. And yesterday I was happy because whom I wrote about her, Stabrak Nur, the smallest prisoner, was free from prison yesterday. She was with me and she came immediately from prison to the tent. I was happy that she was released. She was arrested 14 years old and just for 1 year. I was happy that I saw her, and I was happy that Lina Jabouni released. My trip outside Palestine, this is the first time, but I told you, this is the message, this is the voice of the prisoners. While I was at outside Palestine, in Tunis, my brother phoned me morning. He said that the settlers, Zionist settlers, took 25 dunam of my land in Syria. It was hard for me because my land first, it is mine. It is our olive trees. And it is hard for me because my mother, she plant the trees while she was still girl, because she is the cousin of my father. She until now she is sick. Today morning I took her to a doctor. I tried to help her, to encourage her that my mother, I will collect the olive harvest this year. Even they stole my our land, and I trust my comrade in Italy and Germany, they will come to help me in the olive harvest. It will be battle with the settlers, but I will go on and not will give up. It was hard for me, for first my land, my mother, and third, it is our wealth. Olive oil and olive. Now before we product the olive oil. Now we will buy the olive oil. They took our trees and we will buy it from them. Oh my God, it is our land. So it is hard for us. And what happened with me, like all what happened with all the Palestinian families. So yesterday I was in me and you in the administration, against the Zionist. I was shooted by bomb on my leg. Never mind, I will continue because of my belief that the resistance will return back Palestine. We have a lot of ways, legal resistance, boycott the product of Israel, boycott the culture of Israel, boycott the universities of Israel, boycott the visiting of Israel, surround Israel without buy anything from them, not to deal with them. We will make pressure upon the Israeli with this way, to make demonstration, to be with the families, to continue our studying is very important. So I am with the prisoners in their point of continue the studying at the universities and continue the studying for the young. It is very important.
Thank you. This is Mia Sara Tiani. We are here in the solidarity tent with the striking Palestinian political prisoners on a hunger strike, 75 of whom are in hospital now. And here is a view of the tent.